What is up, everybody? Today we're gonna be doing a chicken Alfredo pasta with a nice little healthy twist. Okay, so it's gonna be super easy to follow, and I'm gonna show you guys step by step. All right, check it out. They said I couldn't do it back when I was broke, going through it. Till I got a deal, now they talking about I knew it. But you wasn't it in the beginning, nowhere to be found when I was down. But you show up when I'm winning. Okay guys, so we're in the kitchen right now, and I hope the audio is okay, because I've noticed on some of my other videos the audio wasn't that great, so I apologize for that. And let me show you guys the ingredients of the stuff we're gonna need. Pan spray, olive oil, Walden Farms chicken Alfredo sauce, and this is calorie free, zero calories, zero fat, zero carbs, zero everything. So this is the game changer. Okay. If you guys don't know about Walden Farms, see if I can get that right there. If you guys don't know about Walden Farms, it is an amazing company. They do everything from like dressings to pancake syrups to marshmallow dip. Everything is zero calories. So go ahead and check them out. You can always get them at Sprouts. All right, and Mrs. Dash tomato basil garlic seasoning. Gluten-free pasta. And this is a penne style pasta. So that's that. We got the chicken already inside the oven. All I did was get a sheet pan. Get some aluminum foil, spray the pan, just make sure it doesn't stick or anything like that. And what I did is I sprinkled a little bit of a Mrs. Dash seasoning on top of it, okay? Cook that at 350 for maybe about, depending on your oven. My oven's actually, it's fairly new, so it works really good. And it is about maybe like 45 minutes, so it should be temping at 180. What I like to do is I like to pull out my chicken like around 170, and I mean the steam is still gonna cook it up. So if I pull it out at 170, I've noticed that the chicken's a lot more juicy and a lot more tasty. So that's a little trick for you guys, okay? All right, so let's get started. Let me bring you guys right over here. Okay, so chicken is inside of the oven, 350. And turn this up here, and let me show you. All right, so we got the chicken all done up, and I actually used a couple of different seasonings just because I'm going to be making two dishes out of this. All right, so for today we're going to be using the tomato basil. So that's that. And next I've got some water that I'm going to be boiling up. Alright guys, so we got the chicken all nicely done, right? So the next step is we're gonna start dicing the chicken, okay? Fairly simple, so check me out and just follow through. Put you guys down there, you guys can see. About this size. Not sure if you guys can see. You don't want it too big, like something like that. Obviously it's too big, right? So you want a bite size, but you want enough chicken in there, you know, because if it's small little cubes, then it's just, it kind of doesn't have the same taste, right? Another thing is you want to keep the seasoning coating on it, all right? So make sure you don't cut it around that. And another tip is make sure your hands are clean. All right, because then you don't want that salty taste on your food. And I'm pretty sure your guests are going to appreciate that. So I'm going to go ahead and cut this up and show you guys the next step. Okay, next step. All right, so we've got our boiling water that's ready for the pasta to come in. We've got our pan and we've got our chicken. Remember how I said the size of the chicken, make sure you keep the coating? That's kind of what you want to go for, okay? And I like to cut at an angle just because I feel like it looks a little fancier when you cut. So anyhow, that's that. And you want to add a little bit of oil. Again, this is olive oil, right? Sure that's on, otherwise it's not gonna cook. I'm gonna add some pasta. Again, this is gluten-free pasta, okay? And I got this at Sprouts. My girlfriend, she is highly allergic to gluten now, so anyways, this works out really good. And I'm actually cooking this for my girlfriend, so I myself am gonna have some of it. But this is mainly for her, okay? So I'm not gonna use that much. I'm probably gonna use maybe like a third of this, just because it's gonna be a lot, especially with the chicken, the sauce, and everything. I wanna make at least 3 to 4 meals that I can pack for her, okay? For lunch and stuff like that, so anyhow. And the main thing, if you're not a big time cook or anything like that, you wanna make sure you stir the pasta a little bit, because if you don't, it's gonna stick to the pan. I'm pretty sure most of you guys know that, but I myself learned how to cook on my own, so there's a lot of stuff that I didn't know. So you always learn from your mistakes, right? So
I'll put a timer on here. Let's see. Timer. I'm gonna go for about, it's usually about 8 to 10 minutes. But let's do 9 minutes. All right. So anyhow, I've got this on here. All right. Next step is you get the chicken. All right. And actually, get the sauce. Get some sauce in there. And let's heat up that sauce a little bit. Mix it in with the oil a little bit. Gets a little bit of a buttery taste. All right. And all you're gonna do is, you're just heating up the oil, you're just heating up the sauce, right? You don't want to put too much of it. This is just going to be for the coating, and then, you know, just to marinate that chicken in there. So it starts getting that. So once we add everything together, we're going to top it off again, all right? So yeah, stir it up a little bit. And remember what I said about stirring the pasta? You got to make sure you stir it, you know? Otherwise, it's going to stick. So, while that's cooking up, I'm gonna be eating my my meal, and I've got some beef in here, some ground beef and green beans, with a little bit of Vietnamese sriracha sauce, and some chipotle seasoning. It's actually pretty good, yeah. So we're gonna let that cook for a little bit, and we'll get back to it, okay? All right, guys, so I've got the pasta all drained up, fully cooked. So just gotta make sure, yep, it's fully cooked. And you're probably wondering, why is it so pale? Well, it's gluten-free pasta, so it's gonna look a little different, all right? But that's nicely done. One little thing that I like to do is I like to drizzle a little bit of olive oil. You don't have to do this, but I myself like it, because keeps the pasta nice and wet. So do that, just toss it around a little bit, then take it back over here, put it in there, and you see how much that made? That actually made a lot. All right, so same thing. Are we gonna do, let's just stir it all up, make sure you get that sauce inside the pasta, add a little bit more, not too much.
All right guys, so we're all done here. Finishing touch, a little bit more seasoning. That's gonna give a little bit more flavor. And again, this is tomato basil, so it's gonna go super good with the Alfredo sauce. All right, plus it's gonna give it a little bit of color where it looks nicer. All right, so I am actually mixing it in right now. There you have it. All right, now I'm gonna put it on a dish and show you guys what it would be like to serve it. All right, ladies and gentlemen, so there you have it. I added a little bit of chives on top just for decoration. You can do that, maybe add a little bit of red bell pepper, give a little bit more color and stuff like that. I didn't have any, unfortunately, but there you have it. Let's take a little taste of it. There you go, delicious. If you love chicken Alfredo pasta, you know that it's super, super high in calories. So this definitely helps a lot with the cravings. It's a healthier choice, yeah? So anyhow, if you guys do like the video, make sure you guys hit like, subscribe, and give me some feedback, guys, because, again, I'm doing all this for you guys. So hopefully you guys liked it, and hopefully I'll give you guys some more recipes, okay? Said I couldn't do it, back when I was broke going through it, till I got a deal, now they talking about I knew it, but you wasn't it in the beginning, nowhere to be found when I was down, but you show up when I'm winning.